Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I am going to be reviewing a product that you guys have been waiting for my review on. It is going to be on the Natasha Denona Sunrise Palette. This is such a beautiful palette. So if you're interested in hearing my thoughts on this palette, seeing this tutorial, then just keep watching. So I know I'm a little bit later than usual on getting this Natasha Denona release up for you guys. I teach PE and this week was field day, which is the event that I'm in charge of. So this week was absolutely crazy for me. So there was a ton of new makeup releases and I really couldn't review or play with any of them because all my focus was on field day. But it has happened. It is done. It went extremely well. I'm very proud of myself. And now it's time to sit down and play with some makeup finally. So let's go into the major facts about this beautiful palette. It is available right now on Sephora, Beautylish, and Natasha Denona. It is $65. And online, it is described as a palette inspired by the warm glow of a morning sunrise with sunny yellows, crimson corals, earthy browns, and powerful pinks, all made to melt together in perfect harmony. I think that is the most perfect way of describing this palette. I 100% agree with everything that is stated online. So the packaging of this guy is the hard case packaging, which I personally prefer. You do on the back have holes so you can push out the eyeshadows if you would like to and put them somewhere else, mix and match, whatever you want to do with it. The front of it is just this beautiful reflective red, and you open it up and you have a big mirror and then of course your gorgeous 15 shades. Inside you are getting almost berry tones, pink tones, yellow tones, and peachy tones. I will say this palette definitely does run a little bit more on the warm side, but it's not too crazy warm like the Sunset palette, but it is warm. Now there are already a bunch of great reviews out there that do comparisons between her different palettes, so I am not going to compare them in this video, but just so you know, look online, there's a bunch of other great reviews that you can check out that do cover that topic. So first thing I want to talk about is the size of this palette. Now you are getting 15 shades in this eyeshadow palette. The overall total grams in this palette is 19.25 grams. This palette is smaller than her regular eyeshadow palettes. The amount of product in her regular eyeshadow palettes are 37.5 grams. So that is almost exactly half the amount. This is $65 and her regular eyeshadow palettes are $129. This is almost right on that half price mark. And I think that this is amazing. And let me explain why. So a lot of times when a brand releases smaller amounts of product, the value of it is not as good. This time, Natasha Denona literally took her palette, cut the amount of product in half, but also cut the price in half. I know for somebody like me, I'm never going to run through the product of her regular eyeshadow palettes, so the fact that I can get the same range of colors with half the amount of product for half the price, I think that that is amazing. I think it is way better for the consumer. It seems that Natasha Denona is going towards this more smaller amount of product route so that it is more affordable to consumers, which, I mean, she's doing a fantastic job of it. So this definitely makes her eyeshadows much more affordable. The typical high-end eyeshadow palette is going to cost you from like $40 to $60. So $65 is definitely right on that cusp, but $65 versus $129, I mean, come on. And you know what? If you are upset that you do get less amount of product in this, literally just buy two of these. You can just buy two of these. It's literally the same amount of product for like almost the same price. Though I don't know if anybody who's really going to be mad about that, because this is still a good amount of product. And to be quite honest, these aren't everybody's everyday color scheme, so I just can't see somebody running through this palette that fast. Now, I did do the math a little bit just to tell you the price per gram of her regular eyeshadow palettes is $3.44. The price per gram in this palette is $3.84. So you're getting slightly over half the amount of products at half the price. I always talk about how I love a brand that offers less amount of product for less of the price, because for me personally, who collects makeup, it saves me money. Because I was gonna buy this palette regardless. But anyways, now that I'm done talking about what a great value this is for Natasha Denona, let's go into the actual shades. So you get 16 shades, and I always like to point out little tips and tricks to help you create looks. So you can actually put this palette in half, and then you get this really pretty kind of neutral light eye with not too much definition. You cover these two, and you get a beautiful berry pink eye, perfect for sunset looks. What I really like about this palette, though, there is this orange shade, is you don't really need orange shades in this palette because the colors blend to create orange, so it really does create a beautiful sunrisey kind of eye. The term sunrise is perfect for this palette. In this palette, you are getting 7 mattes and 8 shimmers, which is a great ratio. I will say about 2 of the shimmers I would consider more of a lid topper, but they are quite pigmented compared to a lot of other lid toppers, but you can definitely tell it feels a little bit different in texture. I'm talking about Aster right here and Awakening, but the rest are her extremely silky, pigmented, shimmery eyeshadow formula. And let's just talk about the shade Morgan right here. There is a shade that is my name, so it's my favorite shade in the palette. More of a reason to buy it, right? The shade Morgan. So I'm going to talk about my overall opinions of the quality of this. I am not going to be shy right away to say that this is such good quality. Every now and then, Natasha Denona will come out with palettes where I feel as if the formula is compromised, especially when she comes out with these mini versions of her palettes. So I was very curious about this palette since it was such a good value and a smaller amount of product, if that would mean the quality of the eyeshadows is compromised. But I can tell you right now, no, it's not. This is the same exact formula of her regular big eyeshadow formulas that we all know and love, and there's no weird playing with different textures in this palette. A lot of times lately, she's been trying to release new cool textures that are new to her brand, and a lot of times it leaves me feeling kind of confused, and I normally don't like those new things that she does. But no, there is no BS in this palette. This is all her real, true formula. The mattes blend super beautiful. I would have loved a deep chocolate brown in this palette, but that's me being picky. This is a sunrise palette after all, so that would be just for me to feel comfortable. But I love the shades in here. They're all so peachy and pretty and warm. She really stuck with the theme on this one. The yellows are very buildable, so you can start off with a very nice soft yellow just to have that undertone in there, or you can build them up. The berries surprisingly blend very beautiful. Sometimes you can find that these shadows can turn out patchy. They go on so pigmented just as they look in the pan. They're soft and they're blendable. The mattes in here really did impress me. They are a little bit more powdery, but if you're familiar with Natasha Denona, you're used to that because they are so powdery, but they are so creamy and they just blend on the lid beautifully. Now the shimmers, I was pretty impressed with the shimmer formula. There isn't a shimmer in here that I would say is wabam pow, absolutely amazing, knock my socks off, but these are good standard Natasha Denona shimmer formulas, and I love them. I love that she has these like crimson red shimmers that really create a fire eye. I feel like not enough people go for those types of colors, but those that really create gorgeous looks. And then you do have some more safe neutral colors right here if you're kind of uncomfortable with these brighter colors. And like I said, there's this beautiful, almost like purpley lid topper. I love that shade. Awakening right here is not as like super shimmery pigmented, but it adds a nice, really soft, ethereal look on the lid. So yeah, I didn't want to go too in-depth about the quality because it's bomb. So I did do a couple of looks. I've played with just about every shade in this palette. Right now, I am going into a really fast-forwarded version of a look that I created the other day. I didn't get to show you the completed look, but just so you can see how the more bright colors played on my eyes, you can see that they laid down very pigmented, they blended with ease, the colors were vibrant, but they could be muted down if I just applied a little bit of product, but they can be built up to be super pigmented. I just think that that first look that I created was so pretty, so sunrisey, and it was so easy to do. And I just feel like the colors I use, sometimes they can go wrong with those shades, but in this palette, it worked and it was good quality. Now I'm gonna go over the look that I'm wearing right now. I wasn't gonna go for such a warm look, but you know what? Sometimes that just happens. So I started off with the shade Morning right here, and I used that as my transition all over shade. This is such a complimentary transition shade to this overall palette. And then I went in with the shade Carnelian right here, which is more of a mustard bright orange shade. Again, really beautiful and pigmented, and it's very easy to build up. I just put that on the outer half of my crease. I then went in with the shade Jasper, which is this more rustic orange red shade, and I blended that into my outer corner. Again, it just applied with ease and blended out so beautifully. And then I finally went in with the shade Agate right here, and I applied that to the inner half of my eyelid. And this is like a very soft yellow shade, but it really brightens up the look, and I just love this really warm sunset look that I have going on with this palette. I mean, so overall, if you couldn't tell, I am quite in love with this palette. This definitely is a hit from Natasha Denona. I love the direction her brand is going in, and a lot of times in most of her palettes there's usually one or two shades that I'm like, these suck, I'm not gonna use these. In this palette, every single one of these shades are great. So everything about this palette really excites me. It is such a pretty color scheme. The quality is stupendous. The price is right. I just think if you are looking into getting a Natasha Denona big palette, this is the one that I have to recommend to you guys, just based on value and everything that this palette brings. I hope to see Natasha Denona continue with palettes like these and of these nature, because I would love to see this size and formula in different color stories, and she could really play up some fun color stories, and I would definitely purchase all of them. Anyways, let me know if you guys have picked this palette up, how you're feeling about it. I know so many of you have picked it up, and there are so many great reviews online. I'm giving this palette a 10 out of 10. I think it's awesome. So anyways, if you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I hope you take the time to do so. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys, have a good day.